House.
Mr. Cohen, do you know Lynn Patton? I'm right here.
Oh, yes, sir.
Do you know Lynn Patton?
Yes, I do.
I asked Lynn to come today in her personal capacity to actually shed some light. How long have you known Ms. Patton?
I'm responsible for Lynn Patton joining the Trump Organization and the job that she currently holds.
Well, I'm glad you acknowledge that, because you made some very demeaning comments about the president that Ms. Patton doesn't agree with. In fact, it has to do with your claim of racism. She says that as a daughter of a man born in Birmingham, Alabama, that there is no way that she would work for an individual who was racist. How do you reconcile the two of those, Mr.
As neither should I, as the son of a Holocaust survivor.
But, Mr. Cohen, I guess what I'm saying is I've talked to the president over 300 times. I've not heard one time a racist comment out of his mouth in private. So how do you reconcile it? Do you have proof of those conversations?
I would ask you to
Do you
ask,
have tape recordings of those conversations?
No, sir.
Well, you've taped everybody else.
That's,
why wouldn't you have a tape?
That's also not true, sir. That's not true.
You haven't taped anybody?
I have taped individuals.
How many times have you taped individuals?
Maybe 100 times over 10 years.
Is that a low estimate? Because I've heard it's over 200 times.
No, I don't think. I think it's approximately 100 from what I recall. But I would ask you,
why
if
would,
you ask me a question,
you,
sir.
Do you have
so
proof?
Here's,
do you have proof?
I
yes
do,
or no?
I do.
Oh, where's the proof?
Ask Ms. Patton how many people who are black are executives at the Trump Organization.
Mr.
And the answer
Cohen,
is zero.
Mr. Cohen, we can go through this. Here, I would ask
you me,
I would ask unanimous consent that her entire statement be put in the record.
Without objection.
All right, let me go on a little bit further. Did you collect $1.2 million or so from Novartis?
I did.
For access to the Trump administration?
No, sir.
Why did you collect it?
Because they came to me based upon my knowledge of the enigma, Donald Trump, what he thinks.
So they paid
you, sir, please let me finish.
No, did they pay you $1.2 million to
yes.
give them advice?
Yes, they did. They, a multi-billion dollar conglomerate, came to me looking for information, not something that's unusual here in D.C., looking for information, and they believed that I had a value.
So how many times did you meet with them?
Was the insight that I was capable of offering them.
How many
times? They were willing to pay.
How many times did you meet with them? For $1.2 million, how many times did you meet with them?
I provided them with both in person as well as telephone access whenever they needed.
How many times? Yes, sir. That's a question, Mr. Cohen.
I don't recall, sir.
So did you ever talk to them?
I spoke to them on several occasions, yes.
How many?
Six times.
Six times. Wow. $200,000 a call.
Sir, I also would like to,
right,
I also
on,
would like
I,
to bring to your attention
This is my 5 minutes,
the contract.
Mr. Cohen, not yours. Did you get money from the Bank of Kazakhstan?
It's not a Bank of Kazakhstan. It's called BTA.
BTA Bank. Kazakhstan BTA Bank. Did you get money from them?
I did.
For what purpose?
The purpose was because the former CEO of that bank had absconded with between $4 to $6 billion, and some of that money was here in the United States, and they sought my assistance in terms of finding, locating that money and helping them to recollect it.
So are you saying that all the reports that you were paid in some estimates over $4 million to have access and understanding of the Trump administration, you're saying that all of that was just paid to you just because you're a nice guy?
Well, I am a nice guy, but more importantly,
well,
each
I
and
would
every,
beg to differ. The record
contract,
reflects that you're not a nice
sir,
guy.
Sir, each and every contract contained the clause in my contracts that said, I will not lobby and I do not do government relations work. In fact, Novartis sent me their contract, which stated specifically that they wanted me to lobby, that they wanted me to provide access to government, including the president. That information, that paragraph was crossed out by me, initialed, and written in my own handwriting, says, I will not lobby or do government relations work.
So Novartis representatives say that it was like they were hiring a non-registered lobbyist. So you disagree with that?
I don't know what they said, sir, but the contract speaks
for itself. Have you ever
contacted
anybody in the administration?
Yes.
To advocate on behalf of any aspect of any of your contracts? I ask unanimous consent, Mr. Chairman. I ask unanimous consent.
The gentleman's time has expired. You may answer the question.
I don't know what you're referring to, sir.
Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Clay.
Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.